Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to crop and display image by using Opencv in Python. So let's get started. So currently I'm having here a super simple code to just display an image, alright? So you can just pause the video and type it out. So if I just now run it, I'll be getting the lion image over here. So this is my image, like the full size of my image. So now let's see how we can crop this image, alright? So here is the like a simple syntax or a code basically you can use to crop an image. So you can just pause it and type it out. So let me just now copy this, all right? And you're just going to have a variable, all right? So you need to just go before or above this im show, all right? And you're just going to like have some space and you're just going to paste this particular, all right? And you need to change this image to your variable name of your image. So in my case, it is img. So I will change it to img. And you need to have a cropped variable. So let crop img be my like cropped image equal to, and you need to just assign this crop image to this im show, all right? Yeah, so this is fine. And next thing is we need to assign this variables, all right? This y, h and x. So by default, like many will be going for y and x as 0, all right? So I will also do the same. So I will just go with 0. And we can basically assign the height to anything. So initially I will go with height as 100 and I will go width as 50, all right? So let me just now comment this stuff, all right? I will just comment this and I will just change it to normal, yeah? So if I just now run it, so here you can see basically this x and y corresponds to like this point, all right? The origin 0 and 0 corresponds to this point, and x basically refers to the distance from left to right, this length, all right? This is the x coordinate, like the x axis. And y basically refers to the height, all right? So height is from the top to bottom, or you can call it that way. So that is the height and this is the width, y and x. I hope that made sense. So if I just now uncomment it and run it, yeah? So if I just now run it, I will change this to crop image, yeah? Crop image. And if I just now run it, so we are getting the image like this. So now I will slowly increase the height and width, all right? So now I will go with height as 200 and the width as 100, all right? So if I just now run it, so here you can see we have got like a top portion of our image. So again, I will change my height to 400 and width to some 200, all right? So I'll just close this again and run it. Yeah, so here this time you can see we have got our lion's face. So now I will just increase the width and not the height. So by increasing the width, we will be able to see the entire face of the lion. So I will go with 300. I'm not changing the height, I'm just changing the width. And if I just now run it, so as I told you, here you can see we are able to see the entire face of the lion. So this is basically how you crop an image. And let's see what happens if we change the x and y value, all right? So I'll just close it now. So you can just play around with height and width, but basically this is the formula. And if I just now go with the x coordinate as something like 50, and I will go with y as 20, and if I just now run it, so here you can see the image has been quite zoomed. It is not from the origin, all right? So if I just now change it to 100, and this one is going to be 70. So I think this will have like a major change. So if you just now run it again, so here you can see basically it has just come down, okay, because of the 70 and the x as 100 value. So you can just play around with that. So in many normal cases, you will be going with 0, all right? And in case if you want to save this particular cropped image as a separate image, you can use the imwrite function, all right? So it's going to be cv2.imwrite, all right? So here we'll be having, so here we need to first pass the image name, all right? So let me name it as crop lion dot png. You need to have the extension as well, and next you need to pass the image name, so which is image variable name, which is crop img. So I'll just copy this and paste it. So by just specifying the file name or the image name alone, our cropped image will be getting saved in the same folder as your project, all right? So it will be getting saved in this particular location because we are not specifying the entire path, we're just specifying the image name, all right? So if I just now run it, so here you can see we are having three files. So after I close this particular dialog box, all right, we will be having the cropped lion.png over here. So I will just close it. So here you can see this new particular image file has been added. So if I just now click it, so we are getting the cropped image as a separate file. And let's suppose say that if you want to like add this image in another folder, like somewhere else, not in the same folder as your .py file means, you need to just go to that particular folder, click here, copy this path, and you need to just add it over here, and you need to put backslash, you need to put two backslash, I guess, wherever you have single backslash. So after doing this, so here you can see I'm just having this particular video. So if I just now run it, so image is getting displayed. If I just now close it, yeah, everything is working fine. And if I just go to the same folder, so here you can see I'm having that cropped lion image appearing over here. So here you can see I'm having the cropped image saved in the some other folder, all right. So this is how basically you save a crop image, and I hope you have found this video useful. I've also learned many other programming videos in Python, OpenCV, C, C++, Java, MySQL, Node.js, MongoDB. So do check other videos off my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.